New information tonight on a murder that we've been following all week. It's got a lot of people talking because the case led police to the house of Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson and prompted an attorney for his grandson, Frank Q. Jackson, to declare his innocence. But tonight, we're learning more about the victim. With the case still open and no one facing charges, his mother told News 5's Emily Hamilton she's looking for justice.
And so it was a name that just stuck with him. So as he got older, we just kept calling him Biscuit.
Wednesday morning was the last time Andrea Parra heard from her son Antonio, who she nicknamed Biscuit. She says he was on his way to buy shoes for a new job. But only hours later, she received a frantic phone call from a family friend.
Biscuit dead. And I'm like, I told the people at my job, I told my coworkers, I said, I gotta go. I said, my son just got killed. I said, I have to go. So I left.
Parra died from a gunshot wound just outside of a barber shop on Clark Avenue Wednesday. And his mother says in the days following his death, she's been left in the dark with no new information.
Because you don't know what's going on. Are you really even trying to find out who did this to him? Do you even care who did this to him?
Today, Andrea says she shopped for the suit and tie she'll bury her 30-year-old son in, a reality that hasn't quite set in.
I don't know. I don't know why he got killed. And then to be for someone to shoot you 8 times.
A vigil honoring Antonio will be held Sunday in Longwood, where he grew up. An exact time and location has yet to be determined. Emily Hamilton, News 5.